want to suggest that I think fishing is dead in this country. I'm just talking about, you know, sort of key environmental things where we're not respecting our coast. And I actually think bringing fishing back and bringing a connection to our own seafood supplies is actually key to that, you know? If we stop thinking of our coasts as food systems, we turn them into waste disposal systems, we turn them into energy extraction systems, we turn them into mining systems. But if we think of them first and foremost as food systems, I think that that's, you know, a good way to start. How to bring young people back into the seafood industry? It's a challenge. Obviously, it's a huge challenge. I think, you know, I am encouraged, and I'm sure, you know, people will also roll their eyes a little bit, but I am encouraged by the relocalization movement that's been happening on a very small scale in terms of community-supported fisheries, systems where you can buy a share basically on a yearly basis for a share of the local catch that's coming from your local harbors. I think getting young people involved, maybe first and foremost on the market end of things, so they can see how the seafood business works. I think there's interesting stuff, I think, going on here in California with some of the collaborative research that's been going on between scientists and fishermen, where you have an opportunity to actually go out with fishermen when you're doing trawl surveys or remote operating vehicle surveys. But you need to get people out on the boat in the first place. You need to kind of get past that sort of hydrophobia in the first place. Get people out on the water. Get people, you know, if not fishing, at least out on boats, at least understanding what's going on. The other thing is, I think for years, fishermen have been demonized, and they've been put in this corner as being, you know, considered sort of rapers of the environment, destroyers of the environment. But when you look at all the different things out there that are affecting the ocean, fishermen oftentimes aren't really the primary issue. A lot of times it has to do with very serious environmental problems that are really affecting the ocean. So I think positive messaging about fishermen and fishing, that fishermen are very cognizant of the environment, that they can be very much engaged with the environment, I think that is one way to win over that young person battle, perhaps. It's really about the way that American fish got rooted into this commodities market. And we separated ourselves from the individual identity of individual fish and the quality of individually fresh caught locally fish. When we have fresh local caught fish, it's a better product. We should be prepared to pay for it. It should represent a larger per pound market share than it currently does. So part of that messaging, I think, you know, getting that plate to that place, the better place in fishing, is starting to break American fisheries out of that commodities chain and getting people to recognize it as a really valuable product. I mean, it's happening, but it's got to be more so than that. The other thing is also, you know, so much American seafood, you know, does get exported, and I would like to see a lot more American seafood, you know, still, I mean, one of the reasons it's getting exported is because countries like Japan, China, Korea, where seafood consumption is 30, 35, 40 pounds of seafood per person per year, are ready to pay good money for high quality seafood. I would like us to be able to compete in that market and not have that fish go abroad and have a chance at that fish before it goes out of our country. You choose. I'm going to let the lady with the mic choose. So fish ranching, so I should just clarify though, there's a couple, people call a couple different things fish ranching. Fish ranching, you know, right now with tuna, they haven't really quite figured out how to do what's called closing the life cycle. In other words, you can't take a tuna quite yet from an egg to an adult, have it spawn in captivity, and then get eggs from it and grow another generation. That hasn't really quite happened commercially yet with most tuna. So as a result, instead of that, what they do is they harvest juveniles from the wild and then put them on the farm and fatten them, usually using forage fish. And the rates in the Mediterranean are pretty abysmal. You know, we've seen something like, it depends, but up to 20 pounds of forage fish required to produce a single pound of ranched bluefin tuna. So all things considered, harvesting juvenile tuna, using that much feed, not a really great environmental solution.